Hello student, welcome back to our computer class. Today we are going to see chapter 5 Photoshop layer and filters part 2. The remaining part of this chapter we are going to see. Okay, so let's start. So we are going to see working with the layers. We already seen some working with the layer, we already done, like we have seen that duplications, yes, that we have seen. So different we have worked with the layers. Now today the remaining we are going to see in this class. So working with the layer, first is flatten layer, means combining all the layers of an image. We are going to combine all the layers of an image. Then merging layer, we are merging two separate layers. Okay, so permanently combine information from two separate layer. In this we are going to merge the two separate layer. Then transform a layer. Okay, so transform a layer, that change the shape of the object in the layer, keep rest of the image unchanged. If you select any layer, okay, it will perform any transformation on that layer only, not it will not affect to the other layer. So rotate a layer means you can move that layer, you can rotate 90 degree, 270 degree, 360 degree, like this you can rotate a layer. Scale layer, you can increase the size of that image, you can increase the size of that layer, or we can say you can increase the scale of that image. Now we are going to see the flatten layer. So flatten layer combines all the layers of an image into one. So you can see here, this image we can move with the help of move tool. Okay, all this image we can move. Okay, so here also you can see in the layers also, here you can see in the layer, see the mouse pointer, there is a layer 4, layer 3, layer 2, okay, and layer 1 and background is there. Okay, so what we will do, we will flatten the layer. So for that you have to click on where, you have to click on the layer tab, click on the layer, there it is a flattened layer is there. Okay, so here you can see there is a flattened image. Okay, click on that flattened image. When you click on that flattened image, you can suddenly see here the background. On the background you can able to see the all the pictures will appear there. Okay, see here, you can see all the pictures will appear on the background only. Okay, all the picture will appear on the background. You can see background, you can see all the pictures in the layers. So flattened layer, in which you can't able to move the picture, you can't able to move the pictures. Okay, so see here, now we will try to move, it will not moving. Okay, means it is giving you the error, means that we are combining all the layer into one. Okay, so it is called a flattened layer. Getting? Okay, now we are going to see merge layer. Okay, in merge layer, this merge layer can be let you permanently combine information from two separate layer. Okay, so you can see here, you can see here there is a layer 1 is there, layer 2 is there. Okay, so you can see here layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, okay, and layer 4 and background is there. Okay, now what we do, we will merge it. Okay, we will merge layer. Okay, so which you want to merge, see here, go to the layer tab. Okay, go to the layer tab, go to the layer tab, in the layer tab, okay, click on the layer tab, there is a merge down. Okay, click on the merge down. When you click on the merge down, okay, two layer will get merged. You can see that Merry Christmas and that house, it will get merged. So here also you can see in the layers also, here layer 1, can you able to see that? Yes, you can't see layer 2 directly, you can see layer 1, layer 3 and layer 4, because layer 2 and layer 3 will get merged. Okay, layer 3 and layer 2 will get merged in layer 3. Okay, see here also how that two picture will get merged with each other, Merry Christmas picture and that house picture. Okay, they will get merged with each other. Now when we try to move, see the both will get move with each other. So these two picture, that is layer 2, will get merged with layer 3, and these two picture will can be move with each other. Whereas you can see here that one layer 1 picture and layer 4 picture will move separately. So merge means they are merging the two separate layer. Okay, they are merging the two separate layer. Getting? Okay. Now we are going to see a transform a layer. Okay, in that we are going to see a rotate a layer. So here we will select the layer 2. Okay, you can see here we will select this layer 2. Okay, layer 2 is our nothing but the Merry Christmas image picture. Okay, after that what we will do, we will come to the edit tab. We will come to the edit tab. In that there is a transform, retransform is there and transform is there. In the transform you can see there is a rotate. Okay, click on rotate. Can you see here? See, okay, see our cursor will change, how our cursor will get changed. Now you can rotate it. Yeah, can you able to see how our image is getting rotated? Yes. So like this our image will get rotated. Okay, getting this rotate a layer. Yes, you can, with the help of this rotate, you can rotate your image. You can rotate your image. Okay, getting? Okay. Now the next is scale a layer. So we, for that we will choose the layer 2. For that we will choose the layer 2. We have choose the layer 3 here, that is that house one. Okay, so now what we will do, we will click on edit again. Okay, we will click on edit tab again. So see here, when we click on edit tab, you have to again come to the transform. Okay, when you click on the transform, there is a scale. Click on the scale. See, that image will get selected. Now you have to scale it, means you can increase the size of that image. Like this you can increase the size of the image. Getting? So this is nothing but the scale a layer. If you want to come out of this, just click on the escape button. See, now I have click on the escape button, we are come out from that scale layer. Getting this? Yes. Okay. Now the next is blending mode. Photoshop blending mode to specify how pixel in a layer should be blend with the layer below. Okay, so you can blend layer to create all kinds of virtual effects in your photo. All kinds of virtual effect you can give with the help of this blending mode. So Photoshop has many blending mode. Okay, you can select any blending mode, changing the appearance of the images. Okay, of that layer, or we can say images, based on the layer and the layer benefit. Okay, so therefore must be at least two layer in the image to be able to use a layer mode. So see here, there are some blending modes. Okay, so normal, that we can see that nothing much change, normal image will appear. Dissolve a black layer under image, enable us to see the effect. Lightening only, image become lighter. Okay, screen light will boost in image. Okay, dodge, that we already seen dodge. Okay, image become brighter and is funky. Then additional, image become brighter. Darken only, image become more darker. Okay, multiple, that image darken but often preserve can burn out. Overlay, brightness and contrast will be added in an image. Soft light is a soft brightness and a contrast add to an image. And hard light is nothing but image become brighter and harder contrast. So we are going to see this hard lightning. Okay, so image become brighter and hard contrast. So this thing we are going to see. Now we are going to see a blending mode. So you can select any layer from here. Okay, so suppose I am selecting a layer 4, that is this boy layer. Okay, now in that there are so many blending modes is there. Okay, but we are going to see the hard light mode. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to select the layer, any layer. So we have selected a, which layer we have selected? This layer 4 we have selected. Okay, layer 4 we have selected. Here you can see there is a normal mode. Okay, that is a blending mode. It is a normal, it is showing. You have to click here. When you click here, so you can see there are so many options are there. Like normal is there, normal mode is there. Okay, like the boy, it will look like, okay, normal. Dissolve is there, then lightning only is there, lightning is there, then screen is there, dodge is there, okay, then there is a darken only, multiply, okay, all these things are there, overlay, okay. So we are going to see the hard light. So you can see here overlay is also there, soft light, hard light. Can you see how the changes in the boy, in the image of the boy, it is looking, see, harder. When we will go to harder, vivid light, okay, linear light, how it will look, okay. So like this it will occur. So we are going to see the harder light, okay. So you can click on the harder light, any blending mode, harder light suppose we are doing, okay, you can select. So it will look like this. Getting? Yes. Blending mode. Okay. Now the next is finalize the project. By using the different tools like scaling, moving, etc., you can adjust the pictures in the frame as per the project. Okay, so we can finalize the project. Now the next is applying a lens flare filter. So if you want to show a lens in your picture or your image, you can apply a lens flare filter. For that you have to select the layer and you have to click on the filter tab. After clicking on the filter tab, there will be a render. In that there is a lens flare, so you have to choose the where you want to that flare window. Okay, lens flare window will open and you have to choose where you want that lens. Okay, and after that you have to click on that okay. So it will shows in your image that lens will appear, layer lens filter will appear. Okay, now the next we are going to see is the applying a lens flare filter. Okay, for that you have to select the layer. So we have selected layer 2 means this big picture, moon picture, okay, picture image. Okay, after that what you have to do, you have to click on the filter, okay, filter tab, you have to click on the filter tab, then you have to go to the render. Okay, in the render you can see easily there will be the lens flare. When you click on the lens flare, okay, this will ask, you can see here, okay, they will ask where you want a lens. Okay, so what I will do, I want this lens on the up here, it should be look like a lens. Okay, so it will shows the 2-2 moon and I will click on the okay. See, can you able to see here, this part is also, yes, I have added a lens to this image here, lens is appeared. See here, there is no lens. Okay, now we will with the help of filter, okay, and render filter, again I am going to show you render filter, in that there is a lens, they will ask where you want that lens. Okay, so I will keep at it is that I want here up only, and then I will click on okay. So see here, you can see the light here, lenses light. Okay, like this it will appear. Got it, how to apply a lenses flare filter. Okay, now the next is saving a Photoshop image. So in Photoshop image, you can save your image in a native image format of Photoshop. This format enables you to retain multiple layers in your image if it has those layer. So you can click on the file, okay, file menu, then there you can click on the save as. There, when you click on the save as, dialog box will open. You have to write the file name, and saves as, at the save as type will become the Photoshop. It will be .psd, .pdd, like this it will appear. You have to click on that and click on save. Your file will get saved. Then the next is saving an image to use it in another application. You can save your image in the format that can be opened and used in another images or pages layout function applications like TIFF, that is tagged image file format, and EPS, encapsulated postscript, are standard print format that are supported by many applications on both Windows and Macintosh platform. BMP, that is bitmap, is a popular window image format, and PICT is a popular Macintosh image format. The next is choosing the file format for an image. So you should choose the format based on how you want to use the image. It is a multi-layered image, or you want to reserve the layer preserve the layer. Save it as a Photoshop. Okay, so if you want to use the image on the web page, save it as a JPEG, PNG and GIF file. Okay, so like this it will work. Now the next, I want to save these pictures. Okay, I want to save this Photoshop image. So for that, what I will do, I will go to the file. Okay, in the file I will choose a save as. Okay, in the save as, here they will ask the name, and you can see here it is already given photoshop.psd.pdd. okay, so I will give the name here, frame, frame, frame. Okay, and I will click on save. Okay, here you can click on okay, so this film frame will get saved. Now again, when we want to open it, okay, now we will close this frame. We will see here, you can see here that the name will appear. Yes, can you see here, the frame name will be appeared. It will saved as a frame.psd. okay, now I will close this. I will close it. Okay, I will open it again. Open. Okay, in open, in a PC picture, what with the frame. Okay, see, frame we have given. Okay, open. See, the same picture will be open. Getting? So like this we can save a Photoshop image. Getting all of you this? Yes. Okay, so in today's class we have learned about the chapter 5, Photoshop layers and filter. In this chapter we already learn about that how we perform the different tasks on the layer, like merging, hiding, duplicating, ordering. Okay, all this, even the deleting the layers, we have seen in this chapter. And also we have seen applying the lenses flare filter in this chapter. We also see the how to save the photo image by using the extension PSD and PDD.PDD. We also see saving an image to use in another application like bitmap, all these things. We also see the choosing the files format for the image. So like this, all these things we have learned in this chapter. Now we are going to meet you in next class with a new chapter. Till then you have to revise whatever I have taught you. Okay, till then take care and thank you.